The thought of extraterrestrial life on other planets continues to inspire books, TV shows, movies, and of course, many conspiracy theories. But there is indeed a real hunt for extraterrestrial life going on right now. And it's not the product of some fanciful science or controversial idea. It is a systematic process that scientists have undertaken, and the results are only expected in a decade. Right now, there are multiple pursuits of extraterrestrial life taking place. In a previous video, we told you about how this process is going on Mars. Probes are also visiting some of the icy moons of our solar system to look for signs of habitation. Astronomers also search the atmospheres of planets beyond our solar system for telltale signs that hint at alien life. We're even constantly on the lookout for possible signals from any intelligent civilization that may be purposefully or accidentally trying to make contact. So far, more than 5,000 exoplanets have been officially identified by NASA missions, but billions more are waiting to be discovered. And that's just in our galaxy. The thing is, our experience of finding distant planets alone makes us wonder. Many researchers and scientists have only intuitively assumed that planets exist outside our solar system, but they weren't identified until our technology and thinking were advanced enough. Does the discovery of extraterrestrial life similarly await our proper scientific age? Based on discoveries made to date, astronomers have recently estimated that more than one-fifth of stars like the Sun harbor habitable Earth-like planets. Statistically speaking, the nearest one may be only 12 light years away, which is practically next door. That in itself is good news for astrobiologists. But in recent years, planet hunters have realized that there is no reason to limit their search to stars like our Sun. Harvard astronomer David Charbonneau explains why.
When I was in high school, we were taught that the Earth orbited a mean star. But that's a lie. In fact, about 80% of the stars in the Milky Way are small, cool, dark, reddish bodies known as eM dwarfs.
If an Earth-like planet orbits an eM dwarf at the right distance, it needs to be closer than Earth is to our Sun to avoid being too cold. It could provide a place where life could take hold just as easily as on an Earth-like planet orbiting a solar-type star. The quest to understand extraterrestrial life aims to explore the potential of life beyond our planet. Despite Earth's turbulent beginnings, marked by intense volcanism and relentless asteroid impacts, life has emerged remarkably quickly in about 4 billion years. This rapid emergence suggests that it may be a common occurrence in the universe, given the abundance of water, organic compounds, and complex chemistry necessary for life. The harsh conditions of the early Earth did not prevent the origin of life. On the contrary, they may have created the ideal environment for it to flourish. New research shows that life began soon after the Earth formed, suggesting that its building blocks were readily available. The presence of water, which is essential, was widespread, along with a host of organic molecules. This rapid start of life on Earth raises questions about the possibility of similar processes on other planets. The observable universe abounds with planets that could potentially support life. However, not all of them are suitable. Extreme temperatures, toxic atmospheres, and other harsh conditions make many of these worlds uninhabitable. Yet the search for life extends beyond these planets to the moons orbiting giant gas planets. Moons like Enceladus and Titan, which orbit Saturn and Jupiter, represent new frontiers in the search for extraterrestrial life. Although far from their parent stars, they generate heat through gravitational interactions, creating subsurface oceans. These oceans could harbor hydrothermal vents similar to those on Earth, where life could potentially flourish. The presence of water and the necessary chemical constituents make these moons prime candidates for exploration. Mars has long been touted as a prime candidate for the presence of extraterrestrial life because of its similarities to Earth. The discovery of ice and seasonal emissions of methane suggests the possibility of life, past or present. However, new theories suggest that Venus, despite its current inhospitable conditions, may have been habitable in the past. The same gas that makes Earth's warm weather possible, carbon dioxide, has turned it into the present fiery cauldron, unthinkable to any life. NASA found evidence that the planet once had a shallow ocean, but because it receives much more solar energy than Earth, scientists believe it evaporated before life could establish itself there. These discoveries are paving new ways to understand the evolution of life in our solar system. The discovery of even the simplest microbial life on Mars or other celestial bodies would have profound implications. It would show that the building blocks of life are universal and that chemical and biological evolution is a shared cosmic phenomenon. Within the next few decades, we may find definitive evidence of life in our solar system, which would change our understanding of the origin of life and its potential spread throughout the universe. Life as we know it needs certain elements, most of which did not come together in the Big Bang. It created mostly hydrogen, helium, and lithium. The heavier elements, such as carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen, formed later in the cores of stars. These elements were dispersed throughout the universe by supernovae, becoming part of the planets and eventually living organisms. This stellar alchemy is crucial for life, being the interconnection between cosmic processes and biological evolution. Planets orbiting long-lived red dwarf stars offer unique opportunities for life because of their stability and longevity, with lifespans of up to 10 trillion years. However, life on these planets will face significant challenges. Red dwarf stars are prone to frequent solar flares that could pose an extinction threat. In addition, the planets around these stars often experience extreme climates, with one side permanently facing the star and the other in permanent darkness. Despite these challenges, the stability and longevity of red dwarf systems make them an intriguing target for the search for life. The potential diversity of extraterrestrial life forms is enormous and limited only by the physical and chemical laws of the universe. Two basic types of extraterrestrial life have been proposed: those with biochemical characteristics similar to Earth's, and those that challenge our understanding of life itself. Carbon, because of its ability to form complex molecules, is probably a common element in extraterrestrial and terrestrial life forms. The discovery of carbon compounds beyond Earth supports the idea that life may be widespread. Convergent evolution is the process by which different species, independent of each other, develop similar traits. It suggests that extraterrestrial life forms may resemble those on Earth. Although the unique evolutionary path that led to the emergence of humans makes the existence of human-like aliens unlikely, similar environmental pressures could lead to the emergence of analogous life forms. Plant life on other planets could adapt with different pigments, resulting in a variety of colors depending on the light spectrum of the star. For example, plants around faint red dwarf stars may appear redder or even black. The color of the alien vegetation is significant, as it can be detected from light years away. It is possible that in its earlier years, our planet had a purple hue due to retinal, a simpler pigment than chlorophyll, suggesting that retinal may be a universal sign of life. Various planetary conditions, such as day length, axial tilt, orbital shape, and gravity, have a significant influence on potential life forms. Planets with extreme orbits could experience drastic seasonal changes, while super-Earth planets with high gravity could support life with robust structures, but could lose their atmospheres more easily. Conversely, low-gravity planets could harbor life in vast underground caves. The smallest habitable planets could have lush vegetation and uniquely structured animals due to low gravity. The discovery of even simple extraterrestrial microbes would be revolutionary, as they would leave biosignatures by producing gases such as oxygen and methane. Advanced space telescopes may soon detect these signs on nearby exoplanets, some of which are only 20 light years from Earth. In addition, life could exist in the cooler layers of brown dwarf planets, which are usually too hot for life. And it is possible that photosynthesizing organisms and complex life forms could be found there. Life can also exist in unexpected places, such as cosmic dust clouds and the extreme environments around neutron stars. Dust particles interacting with plasma can self-organize into DNA-like structures and exhibit lifelike behavior. Since plasma is the most common state of matter, it could also be the most common form of life. Neutron stars, with their intense conditions, could host exotic life forms with rapid life cycles. Moreover, life could be artificially engineered, which would add another dimension to our quest to understand the vast and diverse life forms in the universe. The possibility of life beyond Earth undoubtedly challenges our understanding of biology, chemistry, and the very nature of existence. And if you're curious about when and what the end of the entire universe will be, with our video, you can get there in just a few minutes, right up to the last day, when everything will cease to exist. Click the video on the screen now, and in a second, we'll be back together.